What up, it's your boy Mark, buddy Mark. I don't know. Yeah, I gotta figure out which one I'm gonna do. But doing kind of a controversial song today, Eminem Untouchable. I felt it was appropriate to do with what's going on today. And this is really gonna be like a reaction, because when this came out, I didn't like what he was talking about. You know, talking about what it's like to be a black person when he's white. And I didn't like his flow in the song either, otherwise I would listen to it. I'll when we get to that part, I'll point it out to you. But the song does have a lot of meaning, and especially what's going on right now, it just seemed like appropriate to listen to this. There's some stuff, let's get to the song. I pulled up the lyrics. Well, it was either that or just the picture of the Revival album. I usually don't pull up lyrics, but this song has a message, so I want to catch everything. So, I'll show you the picture real quick. It's just this. And, if it switches, I'll show you more pictures. But, alright, let's get it started. Okay, before it really starts rhyming, this whole first part, you can hear he's talking very softly. I never, the first minute I listened to it, I didn't hear what he was saying. It says, hands up, officer, don't shoot, and I guess it's a cop talking, then pull your pants up, promise you won't loot. Maybe we'll never understand each other, it's no use, we ain't never gonna grasp what each other's going through. So alright, I get that, you know, a white cop gets a call to go into the bad part of the neighborhood, and they do have to protect themselves too, and there are good cops out there, and there are some horrible cops out there, which we've seen. I mean, what happened to George Floyd may be worse than happened to Rodney King, because Rodney King, he lived. George Floyd didn't. And another thing with that, the riots didn't start to Rodney King, or the cops that beat Rodney King got let off, right? They didn't go to jail. Anyway, all right, let's get back to the song. This is a song with the flow. I don't really like the way he's rapping. I like it when he talks clearly, like the Eminem Show, Marshmallows LP, Recovery, Marshmallows LP 2. When he's talking clearly, I like the fast rap too. I didn't like the accents or relapse at all. Anyone that watched me knows that. Alright, so let's keep going. Said, probably coming from the dope house, we could let you slide, but your tail light is blue. Shit, I've been pulled over so many times just for that tail. Fix your tail light. I remember one time it just went out like that afternoon, and we got pulled over that night. Like that gives them an opening to pull you over, and we were all white, but you know, a bunch of people 25 and under in a car, 2 a.m., 3 a.m., you know, they're going to pull you over. And, well, now you gave them an excuse to pull you over. And then they start, have you been drinking tonight? And they start with all the questions. Wow, I'm doing way too much talking, and we're only fucking 40 seconds into the song. Okay, he's talking from the cop's perspective. He's saying, I keep telling myself, keep doing what you're doing, no matter how many lives you ruin, for the red, white, and blue. Time to go find a new one and split his head right in two. That's horrible. No one even indicated you why. And there is the chorus, which is catchy, but I've never read the lyrics like this before, but this is an important message to the song.
No one's ever indicted you. Why? Because you're a black boy, black boy. You're a rock star.
I like the hook. It's very catchy. But no, it's not true, though. Okay, of course, that's again. I'm white. I've been harassed by the police a few times. You know, for basically for the way I dress. Maybe if I was dressed like this and a nice shirt and a tie, I'm sure I wouldn't. But a white kid, I've been called, I hate this word, I've been called a wigger, a thug. I've been called white trash, I've been called it all, but a wigger a lot. That's the one that bothers me the most. Why? Because I like rap music, I'm wearing baggy jeans, a hooded sweatshirt, Timberland boots. And I got stopped, the time I got stopped by the police, for no reason, walking down the street. No reason. They said someone robbed a laundromat, and they asked what was the description. They said white or Hispanic kid with a hoodie, baseball cap, and jeans. That's fucking a lot of fucking people. And if you robbed a laundromat when you have a lot of change, come on now. They did not stop me for that. I was hustling the time, but I had nothing on me. Our guns are close to our hands. You better show your hands. Here come the swine. That's another word for pigs. But there's good cops up there, so that's probably why he didn't say pigs.
Americans have been treated like shit, and I admit there have been times where it's been embarrassing to be a white boy.
That I so disagree with. I'm not embarrassed to be white because of some of the horrible acts that white cops have done. Like, you can't be embarrassed, like, for things that you had nothing to do with. Even family. I got a cousin that's done some stupid shit. Not racist shit, but some bad shit. And am I supposed to be embarrassed because I'm related to him? Or we honestly barely know each other. I disagree with that so much. Embarrassed to be white because, you know, like, should I feel embarrassed right now because what that cop did to George Floyd? And the three cops standing around couldn't be more diversity. There's an Asian cop. There was a Hispanic cop, and there was a black cop. All three sat there and did nothing. All right, let's get to the song. This video is going to be long. But it should be your child with serious issues. I do like the hook. It's catchy as fuck.
Lifespan of a white man is more than twice than a black lifespan. I wonder sometimes if it has a price scanner. I feel like checking out a life scanner. Escape the circumstance. I'd rather hear him say die inward than die outward. Ninja, now it's better disguised banter, but that's life. Strapped because we're strapped financially and can't find answers. We're applying for McDonald's. It seems to be the only franchise that'll hire. So how can we have higher?
You gotta be able to get a better job at McDonald's. You should be able to. twice when I've been in bad times in my life, I just got a job at the local supermarket unloading trucks. Anyone can do that job, and then when there's no trucks, you bag groceries. It's embarrassing, but you know, you do it 40 hours a week, it pays the bills. That's temporary till you figure something out. I did it when I first got out of detox, and I didn't know what to do next. I was like, all right, right now I'm just gonna get a job at the supermarket that's a 5-minute walk from my house, a 2-minute drive. Anyway, back to the song. Overshadows the battle for Black Lives Matter. We fight back with violence, but acts like matter. Black eyes on the movement, which makes Black Lives Matter. At cops and cops matter. That's why it's at a stalemate. They can't arrive. Right there, that's true. He's saying, which Black Lives Matter. At cops and cops matter. That's where the stalemate. Because, yeah, cops lives matter too. Alright, let's get back to the song. And I compromise, so it's black ops. I wonder if we that's why we can't compromise. The crap stops. The block is our backyards. Officers not interesting crap. Thought if we hired more black cops. Because I was friends with this girl. And her parents lost. The father lost a job. And she moved to Dorchester. Like the ghetto. And I remember taking the train out there. And the only white people were the police. It was all black people, but the police looked like skinheads. They all had shaved heads. They had so many tattoos, sleeves of tattoos. They looked like skinheads. And it's like, really? Those are the type of police you want to put there? Shouldn't you grab some black cops? I don't know. I think he's right there. Maybe you should send the black cops into the black neighborhood. It makes sense. I hope I'm not coming off sounding racist. I just think that makes sense. Spot, call the attack dogs off of us, man. You always act all pissed off at us at a traffic stop. Bad cops, fuck it up for the good cops. And man, stop sending white cops. There are so many good cops out there. And there's probably 95% good cops and 5% bad. About that. In the black neighborhoods, we ain't acclimated to them like that's the way to do it. We've seen some fucking videos of rappers waving guns and know nobody black, so they act afraid of us. And that's racism, the fear that a black face gives them. A subconscious racist. Wait, why are there black neighborhoods? Subconscious racist. Segregated us. It's like you might not think you're racist till you find yourself in the hood and you're looking around and ain't no one else white. And you get a little scared. Is that racist? I don't know. But when you're getting dirty looks left and right, it's just, I don't know. Just being a little scared, it's nothing to be ashamed of. You know, just, there's no reason to be. It's, I don't know. That's a tough issue. This whole thing is a tough issue. Separated us, sectionated us. They just want a safe environment for the kids. Why are they all put into a bad part of the neighborhood? Why is it Section 8? I know if they make good money, they can move out, but why are they put there to begin? Doesn't all make sense to me. The scientists to see our violent nature lies in the poverty that we face, so the crime rate the highest in the lowest classes. It's like a razor wire fence we're trapped in. These racial biases that plague our society, which makes our anxiety levels raise every time we see a devil's face. They plague our society, which makes our anxiety levels rise. I have anxiety, and I get that. Tigers and pears, oh my. It's more like Billy clubs and gas, and we really love it when you think we're guilty because we're black. But you kill each other, bats, you kill each other's cats for silly stuff like hats. Single mothers struggling through substance abuse while people with nothing to lose shoot each other for shoes. Now he's talking about what some of the black people do to each other in the hood. Still kill each other for shoes. It happens. It's horrible, but it's true.
Fuck your Republican views. Pull myself up by bootstraps. What a fuck on a boot. The streets act as a narrative. Don't gotta read comics or be that into characters. Just to see that, just to be black, you better be strapped with a derringer. Or be Captain America.
Captain America.
Cause no one oversees these cops. And all we see is some beat charges. We done seen them beat Rodney King unconscious and got off. So
we see them beat Rodney King and got off. I just said I thought he got off, then the riots start. What, the guy who killed George Floyd, he got arrested, he's in jail. I don't know what's going on with the other three cops, but they should all go to jail too. Maybe not life, but, they should all go to jail too. Why are we rioting now? The guy, it makes no sense. The protesting, the people that are rioting are just used as an excuse. They probably don't know the name of, they probably don't know George Floyd's name. But the people that are protesting, there's a huge difference. The protesters that have the chant and have their signs, they come out daytime. The rioters, they come out at nighttime with baseball bats or a gun. You should be able to tell the difference.
Wicked police officers, peace offerings. Just keep marching. Till we reach Congress, but they're gonna say you're trying to take an irrational stance if you try to slander the flag. But somebody has to be the sacrificial lamb, so they call it a Kaepernick tantrum if you don't stand for the national anthem.
We raise it, I don't like it anyone stand.
You'll be made to feel like a traitor will treat you like Rodney Dangerfield, home of the bravest still, racist still. So this whole nation feels like a plantation field in a country that claims that its foundation was based on United States ideals that had its natives killed. Got you singing the Star Spangled Spiel to a piece of cloth that represents a land of the free that made people slaves to build.
Okay, so that's the end of the song.
Yo.
Now the next one to stop, but boy, people that read the lyrics talk about cheating. I mean, like, that made my job so much easier to break down what he's saying. And not, this one wasn't loaded with bars, but geez, I know. What, I don't want to talk shit about my other YouTubers, but some of them who just read the lyrics are just cheating. But there's one beautiful girl that does it, and I get it. Why would you watch me over a beautiful girl? But I truly love hip hop, and I don't even know if she likes it. But anyway, it's a very controversial video. I'm sorry to make it this long, but it was an important video. And alright, I hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully the riots slow down. Hopefully they stop. And the protesters, they need to stop because they're opening the door for the riots. And I just hope. I hope by tomorrow when I see you guys, things are better. Because they're better than they were yesterday. So let's keep going in that direction.